Hey everyone, Cory Calvin here with FCP Euro, and today we are going to be changing the valve cover gasket on this Mark V R32. So as you can see here, I have a couple more parts than the actual valve cover gasket itself, and that is because it's a pretty big job to get to the valve cover. We have to remove the intake manifold, and while that is off, it's a good opportunity to replace all these parts. We have the bolts for the valve cover with rubber seals, the spark plug tube seals, the intake manifold gasket, and the PCV valve itself. While the valve cover is off, this is the only time that you can access this, so it's a great time to replace it before it fails. So the reason we're doing this job today is because we can definitely see some oil seepage from this valve cover gasket. So just like any other rubber gasket, they tend to harden over time and begin to leak. So on this Mark V R32 behind me, I am going to need to remove the bumper and put the front end in the service position. So the processes I'm going to show you today are going to be very, very similar to any other model that comes with the VR6 engine, such as Audi Q7, Porsche Cayenne, the Audi TT, and any other Audi or Volkswagen that came with the VR6. So enough talking about the job. Let's take a look at the tools required. So these are the tools required to complete this job. You are going to need a small torque wrench that does between 10 and 20 newton meters, various ratchets, various extensions, a 5mm and a 6mm long ball and Allen sockets are definitely crucial. Various Torx bits, a couple iterations of 10mm triple squares just for the manifold brackets. So a mirror can help you view into the hard to see areas, especially around the cylinder head to intake manifold connection. A magnet just in case you drop something, gasket scraper, various screwdrivers, and an impact gun definitely helps loosening the radiator support. Some other things that you'll need is a little bit of oil-resistant RTV and some Loctite for the bolts. So that's enough talking about tools. Let's dive right in. So first, I'm going to remove the bumper and put the front end in the service position. Obviously, for the purposes of this video, we're using a lift. But if you're at home doing this, you could easily use a jack and jack stands or even potentially just do it on the ground underneath the car. So first, we're going to start by removing the eight T25 screws for the fender liners and the bumper to the radiator support. So I already took these out. This was missing. All right, so next we are gonna turn the wheel in to access the two T25s on the fender liner here. And then there's one more, I believe it's a T20 or T25 here holding the end of the bumper, but as you can see, it's already torn off. So as always, I'm gonna apply a little bit of tape to the fenders just in case the bumper scrapes it. So just repeat the same process on the other side. First thing we're gonna do in the bumper removal, on the Mark V's, you need to remove the grill. Since this is a one-piece grill, we're gonna have to remove these lower bezels and then two T20s right here. So now with the bezels off, you can reach in here and remove the side marker light. So now with this bezel off, you can get to the headlight washer hose. You can pop it off here and then plug it real quick with a vacuum cap so the reservoir does not empty. Don't lose that clip. So I'll twist it a little bit, pop it off. And put a vacuum cap on it. So now I'm gonna remove the four T25s on either end of the grill here. Next is the two T20s underneath on each side. And now the last two bolts holding the grill on, one here and one directly on the other side. And then pull these tabs and lift up the grill. And then pull and lift. Pull. Lift and the grill should pop off. So now that we have all of the screws underneath and on each side taken off, the only ones remaining are these two right here, and they are T25s. So now I'm going to slide the bumper out. It's easy just to work it one side at a time and just make sure nothing is hanging you up. Make sure that's free. Okay. And away we go. So moving on to more radiator support stuff. We're going to remove the four T30s on either end of the radiator support right here. While you're working in this corner, now's a good time to pop off the hood latch and just make sure you have a lot of slack in the line. So I always like to mark the bolts before you remove the radiator support. Obviously there are going to be witness marks, but it's good just to mark them anyways, just so it's real easy to line up when you're finished. So before I remove all these bolts, I'm just going to unplug the horn on either side. Now I'm going to remove these four 16 millimeters. I'm not going to take the bottom bolts all the way out, but I am going to loosen them pretty far. So as you loosen the last bolt, just hold it with your hand and make sure we have a controlled descent. There we go. All right, so in the engine bay, first thing we are going to tackle is the intake tube and the airbox. Obviously, this is an aftermarket intake, so the steps will vary slightly from removing the OEM one, but generally it's the same concept. So we are going to unplug the MAF, disconnect it here. So let's see if we can just pull it off in one big piece. There we go. So instead of jumping around the engine, we're going to start on the right-hand side and work our way over. So we're going to start on this side by removing the 10 millimeter nut and the ground and the stud underneath it, and also this T30 here for this bracket. And this T30. So next, I'm going to remove the harness from the clip here, throttle body connection, and the PCV connection there. As well as the vent purge solenoid. So now I'm just going to remove the harness for the throttle body, the PCV connection, and the EVAP. And lay it over here. Next, I'm just going to remove all the connections for the coil packs. So these break really easily. As you can see, this one is already a little broken. So I'm going to reach in here with a pick and lift up the tab. So now that we have all the coil packs unplugged, you can go ahead and pop off this cover for the coil pack harness. It comes off pretty easily. And lay it to the side. So next step is to remove the connection for the PCV breather to the intake manifold here. So easy way to do this is pry on one side until you feel it move, pry on the other a little bit, and then wiggle it off. Be careful, because as these age, they're very easy to break. And then continuing the progress, we are going to disconnect everything on the back of the intake manifold here. here. So that the easy way to remove this is to press it forward a little bit, press the tab, and it'll pop right off. So disconnect that. And then these are a little bit more difficult. So instead of fighting the brake booster connection on the back here, it's easier just to unplug it right at the booster itself and work it off. So now the only line left we have is the evap line. So rotate it around until you can feel the little tab. Is on the bottom side, push it in, press it, pop it up. So now the only thing that's left is this bracket back here. Just bend it down a little bit with your hand, then you can access it with a 10 millimeter treble square. So now I'm going to remove the throttle body, and that has 4 5-millimeter Allen. So next we're going to remove these 2 10 mils for the fuel line bracket here. So next we are going to remove the 2 10 millimeter triple squares for the intake manifold brackets. And then next I'm just going to remove these 2 T30s down here. One is for the dipstick tube, the other is for bracket for the solenoids down here. And then next, I'm going to remove this vacuum line right here for the intake flaps. So next, we're going to take our long ball-headed 6 millimeter Allen and undo all of the intake manifold bolts. Now you kind of have to get these by feel. They're difficult to see except for the two corners. So we'll just show you when I'm finished. So a quick little tip when you're looking for bolts that you can't really see, this is the orientation of them. So as you can see, there's 2 on these corners here and the rest are pretty easy to follow. You could also count how many bolts you took off versus how many bolt holes are in the gasket. So we took out a total of 9, so we are good to go. Now that we have everything disconnected and the manifold's loose now, the only thing stopping it is the heads of the coil packs. So we're just gonna go ahead and pop those out. So now, to make it easier to remove the intake manifold, it helps just to tweak the dipstick back a little bit. No harm in that, because as you bolt it, it's gonna go back into place. So this morning, before we started working on the car, I noticed that it had a couple water spots on the ground. So I looked up underneath it, couldn't really see much, so I figured we'd probably see more once we took the intake manifold off, and lo and behold, the coolant temperature sensor O-ring was leaking coolant everywhere. So while we're in here, put a new O-ring on it and he should be good to go. This old O-ring is really flattened,
And you can see the dried coolant all around it.
So first, we're just gonna clean up the area. And I'm just gonna dry it off real quick. And we are ready for removal. You wanna start from the outside and work your way in. And these are 10 millimeters. There we go. Lift it up off of the studs. So now we are gonna remove the old gasket. And a spark plug tube seals. All the bolts. Now you can see why we suggest changing the PCV while the valve cover is off. Only time you can get to it. So now you have to take off the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 T20s. And 5. Now that all of the bolts are loosened, use a flathead to very gently break the seal on this side. And then it should pop right up. So there's your PCV valve. So first thing we're reinstalling on this job, brand new PCV valve. Take a little bit of oil from the breather port, rub it on the O-ring. And you can lower it down in. So it'll take a little persuasion to get it sitting all the way. That's why you want to lubricate the O-ring real good so that you can make sure it doesn't roll over or get sliced. Just make sure this vent is clear and the gasket is seated all the way over here. Now we put the 5 T20s back in. Now that I have the PCV in, we can lay down the valve cover gasket and pop the new bolts. All right, now we can pop in our spark plug tube seals. There is a little notch that you do have to line up right here. Now we're gonna go to the front of the car and just clean up the gasket surface. Just spray a little bit of brake clean on the rag. Wipe it down. If you look closely here, you can see the crack in between the timing cover and the actual cylinder head. Had silicone on it before, so we have to put silicone on it again. Also, I like to add a little dab of silicone to these corners here. Using a gasket scraper, I'm just going to clean up the remaining silicone here. And then repeat for this side as well. So you can use pretty much any oil-resistant RTV. Put a small dab of RTV on that corner there, and on that corner there. That corner there. This corner. So now, I'm going to flip this over and reinstall the valve cover. Just make sure the valve cover is good all the way around. Now, I am just going to zip these down in a circular motion, inside outside. Thank you. So these 10 millimeter bolts and nuts get torqued to 10 newton meters. I like to do a couple passes working up to 10. The goal here is to equally distribute the load as you're tightening it down. All right, so now we're just gonna go around one more time, double checking every fastener. There we go. So now I'm gonna replace the intake gasket. I'm just using a pick to pull on the gasket. So now I'm just gonna take a rag, wipe it real quick, just to make sure we get a nice good seat with the new gasket. So we're gonna lay our new gasket in, press in these little seals. Now we are ready for reinstallation. So now I'm just gonna take a rag and wipe the intake ports. Again, the idea here is just to have a nice clean mating surface for the new gasket. So as you feed it down, just make sure that the wiring harness here doesn't knock the gasket out of place. So before we slide it home, it's like a good idea to just eyeball it and check it. There you go. A little trick to help the bolt stay on the socket is just add a little bit of grease. Creates a seal and doesn't like to fall off. And as always, I love Loctite. So I added a little bit of blue Loctite just to make sure they won't back out. So I'm going to start with the two corners. Again, I'm just tightening them down a little bit at a time, starting with the middle and working my way out. Now that I got everything snug down and tighten, I can go ahead and torque them, starting from the middle, top bolts, bottom bolts, and then ends. So these all get torqued to 13 newton meters. So after we have the manifold on and torqued, so vacuum canister first, because there is a little tab that you have to line up down here that you obviously can't see. Get the dipstick lined up. Those are T30s, and they're just 6 millimeter threads, so don't put a lot of torque on them. They just need to be nice and snug. And then the vacuum line for the intake flap. Next, we are gonna put in the coil packs. Just lay the harness here so you can see the orientation of every coil pack. Tab this way, tab that way. Push them in until you feel them pop. Now we're gonna plug in all the coil packs. Now I'm gonna move on to the two side manifold brackets. Now we're gonna put on the bracket on the back side of the motor here. Remember, this side gets the stud because it has the ground on it. Now I'm just gonna tighten both of these 10 mils. Get the ground on. Here.
Next, I'm gonna plug in our PCV connection here. Before I do anything else, I'm gonna get this back engine bracket. And tighten the 10 millimeter triple square. Now, I'm gonna get the rest of my vacuum lines back up here. But we cannot forget about our brake booster hose. I'm gonna lie the wiring harness here. This is for the throttle body. PCV valve. Now we can put the throttle body back on. Now we can tighten down all the throttle body bolts, and these are 5 millimeter Allens. Again, these are very small diameter threads, so they don't really need a lot of torque. There we go. Plug in the throttle body. All right, intake. So now I'm just gonna lift the front end and hold it into place with some of the T30s that I removed from here. So now I'm just gonna thread in by hand all the radiator support. Now we're just gonna plug in the horns. Now I'm just gonna line up the radiator support on the top side with the witness marks and tighten them down. Again, these are T30s. Now we can reinstall the front bumper. Now, we can put the side markers back in their homes. Now, we can reattach our windshield washer hose. We can put on his grill. And don't forget about the T20s underneath here. Now it's time for the grills. Now we can reattach the T25s for the top of the grill here. Okay, now we're gonna go up to the rest of the bolts underneath. I'm just gonna finish reattaching fender liners down here. There we have it.
we're all finished replacing the valve cover gasket and PCV on this R32. As you can see, it's a fairly involved job. The hardest part is getting the manifold off of the engine. Other than that, the process is fairly simple. So thanks for watching. I hope you found this video helpful. If you want more information about your Mark V R32, be sure to visit fcpeuro.com and check out our Volkswagen pages. If you have any questions, leave a comment below and be sure to like and subscribe for more content. Thank you.